Hey, Instagram. This is your friend, your girl, your sister, Tahiri Divine, coming to you with another video, live and direct. I really like this filter. This filter is very sultry. But you can find me on all my social sites as Tahiri Divine. Check out my YouTube. And Tahiri Divine is where you can find practical spiritual tips on how to use these spiritual tools in your everyday life, from astrology, tarot, and the oracle cards. I like to incorporate these tools in my life to uplift myself spiritually, financially, and in my relationships, and so on. So I share my journey with you, and hopefully it does something for you as well. I want to talk to you guys because you guys know it's Feminine February, where just about every week I will be giving a different principle, if you want to call it that, of the divine feminine, what the divine feminine is. We shared that in another live. I hope you guys caught it. If not, it is on my YouTube channel. The most recent one I did was adornment, and I wanted to speak on that one just a little bit more about what adornment really means and what it is. I share with you, it's an act or a ritual or a rite that you perform on oneself. And adornment could go from the way you do your hair, the clothes you wear, the jewelry, the makeup, the perfume, cologne. So adornment is not limited to just women. As I shared with you guys, the feminine principle is neither male nor female. We all exemplify these principles, right? And sorry if my phone is like wiggling. It's because I'm holding it instead of having it propped up like I usually do, only because I'm charging my phone and I just wanted to get this message out because it was on my heart and I need to share this. This has been a very, very interesting month for me. I think I read somewhere where somebody said, you know, February is the new January. And honestly, that just feels so real. I totally get it. I get it. And so, you know, we're coming off the cusp of the full moon in Virgo, and I want to talk about restoring your faith in yourself, right? And when we say restoring our faith, many times, and I'm just going to share from my personal experience, and if it relates to you or resonates with you, then, you know, we are part of the same soul group. Hey, soul group, how are you? Many times we don't have faith in ourselves because there was lack of follow through in our own life, right? So let's say there was something that you don't have faith that you can complete, or you don't have faith that it'll come to pass, because we usually like to attribute that to unworthiness, but unworthiness comes from a place of a lack of follow through. And when you don't believe in yourself, or you don't have the faith that you will do something, and faith is action. Faith has nothing to do with just hoping and believing. That's what hope is. Hope is just believing it will happen. Faith is doing the work that will guarantee it will happen. It's like when you're doing push-ups, right? You don't hope you're gonna get muscles in your arms or whatever. You have faith that you will, because you're doing the actual work that will lead to the muscles in the body, right? The building of muscles. And so the same thing applies to whatever area in our life, whether it's manifesting love, whether it's starting a business, whether it's economically growing, whether it's moving forward in your career, changing your lifestyle in whatever way that you need to change it in. Follow through is going to be one of the most key important things. And I want to discuss why we don't follow through. I know for myself, I had a lack of follow through, and I'm healing and coming out of that part of my life because of not feeling adequate or deserving. And so a lot of us come from a place of thinking we're undeserving, and these feelings or thoughts come from typically childhood. It could be some things that were said to us. It could be, I could say for like my generation, those who have Neptune and Capricorn, we grew up in a generation where it was, if you work hard and give your best, you succeed in life. And many of us lived by that, and if we did those things, and then sometimes many times too, your value was based on how much you produced. And if you did do your best, let's say your best wasn't equivalent to what success was being told to you, right? So therefore, now you gave your all, you did everything you were supposed to do, you're told, and you didn't reach the pinnacle of success, or whatever situation life you were striving for. Or it wasn't appreciated, or it wasn't even deemed as the best of what the best supposedly was supposed to look like. So therefore we start to now judge our own selves and our own character and our own abilities based on not living up to somebody else's standard. And you're doing your best to live up to a standard that's not necessarily your own. And so there comes this lack of trust in self. And then it kind of can turn to something else. And I can say for my own self, because I grew up in a very verbally critical family, it stunted me in a lot of ways. I was afraid to even try because I didn't want to fail. So, and hence, I did not fail because I did not try. But you fail if you don't try. And then you start something, but then you give it up because you don't believe it'll ever go somewhere. And a lot of times we give up on things too soon. We give up too early. And so what does that have to do with feminine February? It has everything to do with the different principles I'm talking about. When we talk about rest and restoration, when we talk about receiving, when we're talking about insight, intuition, inner authority, self-nurturing, these are traits and principles that we must apply on our own self so that we can heal those parts, what we call the inner child, that inner wound that tells us that we're not good enough, that tells us that we're not great enough, that tells us that the lies that tell us that we are just not worthy of whatever it is that we're striving for, working towards, especially if it's something that's our heart's desire, especially if it's something that's so big that nobody else in your family or nobody that you may have known is accomplishing that very thing that's on your heart and your mind and soul to accomplish. And so I want to give these practical solutions. I'm about practical spirituality. What are some practical things I can do to really help myself, you as well, in accomplishing this, having faith? So like I said, we off the cusp of the Virgo full moon, and that was really, like I said, about restoring your faith in yourself and restoring that inner work. Because anybody knows a Virgo energy, Virgo is a very helpful, get it done, pointing out the problem, a lot of people say, but they're usually pointing out to what areas can be resolved, what can be fixed, what could be better. And that's what we need to do in our own selves. And so when we're taking these times to looking at the fear and realizing the fear is just that part of ourselves that may just actually do well. really, people don't really fear failure. Honestly, we fear doing really well because we start to think that if I do well at this thing, I may have to leave something behind. I may have to let go of an excuse. I may have to let go of people. And that is sometimes the most fearful thing to do, is maybe letting go of some things that you have grown attachments to. And realizing that the things that you may, things or people, behaviors that you have grown these attachments to are really not of your best interest. And so now you have to take a leap of faith in doing something different. And now you have to be your own encourager within that, because there may not be anybody around to encourage you. I don't know the exact psalm, but I can remember it was David had to learn to encourage himself. It was during a point where he was the leader of this army, whatever, and he was leading his men to battle. And pretty much while he was out with his men on battle, they got word that their families were captured and killed by their enemies. And so the men of David's camp wanted to conspire against him, right? And David was completely just, you know, he's their leader, and while he's supposed to be leading them to victory, they're getting news that their families have been, you know, annihilated, and they want to take him out because he's their leader. And so what David had to do within that moment, he had to encourage himself because he lost things too, but he didn't have time to sit there and weep and cry about it because he's their leader. And so not saying that you don't cry about it, not saying that you don't feel, but there has to come a point where you have to be your own encourager. You have to be your biggest support system, because there's not going to always be outside sources to support your high beliefs, right? Or what the things you may be trying to do. So I'm saying here, when we're talking about this feminine February and these divine traits that we have within ourselves that we can tap into,
it comes to a point where now you have so much faith in yourself that you're going to adorn yourself and the very behaviors, all right? Adornment is a behavior, it is a right, is an action. You adorn yourself with faith. You adorn yourself with courage. It's like, I wear the breastplate of righteousness, the helmet of truth, or is the sword of truth, the helmet of, I got to get back into my word, y'all, so I can give it to you guys right. But all of these things tie into each other. Nothing's separate from each other. And so I wanted to talk to you guys about how to restore your faith in yourself by the adorning of yourself. It's not just about the outward things that you do, but those outward things that you do are a representation of your inward self, right? And so if you guys look back at my the picture that I put by the artist, oh God, I forgot the brother's name. But the picture actually breaks down a, was the picture? I believe it's the picture under that. Yeah, I believe it's the picture I think I have in my description of what the adorning of the body represents on a spiritual level and what you're saying about yourself and how you carry yourself and what you do to follow through because you believe in the divinity of who you are and you walk in it. And because you are that, you just be it. Thank you guys for tuning in. I'll come back with you guys with some more divinely spiritual incitement tools and tips that can help you practically in your life. Thank you. Peace.